shows you that
so far.
There is no reason. Like, if somebody says, oh, I'm the president of XYZ organization, then you know that that guy's a fucking douchebag because we have no history of people doing the right thing.
Yeah.
The NCAA, fuck them all.
You guys, you probably heard this.
First of all, I welcome the asteroid that will destroy our society.
It's coming.
Our society has got it coming.
Wait a minute. You think we're actually going to wait for an asteroid?
Yeah. Well, you know, I'm just hoping.
I'm not
it's
saying
a race
it
with time
coming,
at this
but,
point.
I hope it lands
on the Sandusky statue. I think that's where the destruction of our society should begin.
Sandusky has a statue?
I don't know.
At the Vatican?
Not Sandusky. Anyway. All right. Paterno. Paterno's statue.
He's got a statue.
Actually, you know what? He's in the background of Paterno's statue.
I think Sandusky wanted a statue of limitations, but...
What a bing. Yeah, that's why he's a doctor, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right.
It's also Super Bowl Sunday is a huge day, big win for domestic violence and wife beaters. It's like the
they
the
do
most,
say that.
Yeah, it's like National Wife Beater Day. And
I will
well,
be sure
you know
to
what?
Wear one.
You know what?
Yeah,
I got two things to say. One, don't get in front of the TV.
Kind of asking for it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And there's things that ladies can do to minimize and to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And two, if you have questions about the game, ask them before the game or after the game.
Yeah.
Right.
Or during the halftime show.
Become familiar with replay. Don't go, oh, they're doing it again.
And slower.
Yeah.
Cards and letters. Send them to David Robinson. He said that last part.
Yeah. So anyway, that's why, I mean, it's one of the reasons. We're going to the beach. We're giving my wife a break.
Yes,
go to
this
the beach.
Year she won't get hit.
Beat her in nature.
Yeah. Yeah, that's going to be weird. Like beating your wife at the beach. Nobody sees that.
No.
That'll be...
No.
That's going to be great. You know who else is going to win this weekend? Doritos enthusiast.
Oh.
It's a big day.
Has anybody... I'm a little under the weather, so I'm trying to cough away from the microphone.
I thought you were hacking up a Dorito. No.
But have you seen the Doritos? Is there another round of Doritos commercials that we have to watch? We have to watch all of our friends that made Doritos commercials?
Yeah, they're doing the contest again.
Because I saw one and it was like, well, this is from last year. It's the one where the guy's got Dorito crumbs on his crotch and the hot girl's running past, you know. And then, of course, the big guy always pushes the girl out of the way and, you know, we assume some homosexual act takes place.
Oh, nice. Okay.
That's one of them.
Okay.
Well, when the chips are down.
Didn't win. Yeah, that's right. Have you seen any this year?
No, and I refuse to watch any.
I can't do it anymore. Yeah, I watched a lot of bad ones, and then there's some good ones, but it's like
I would watch
I'll let
one,
somebody else filter it.
I'd watch one if there was one like somebody choking and dying on a Dorito, and then
someone does the Heimlich, and it pops out, and then someone else eats it.
Yeah, or maybe like somebody like guzzling Mountain Dew, just projectile vomited to something. Something that, that I could
get behind. Yeah.
But
I really think, Randy, we should talk about opening an ad agency because we may not land any clients, but I think we'd certainly produce some amazing, amazing ads.
Yeah.
And then if you see in this last card, we show everybody is dead. They've eaten the Doritos, but do you notice they're happy? They're dead, but they're happy.
They're happy, yeah.
Doritos, I guarantee you die happy.
I need to give a little personal anecdote, if I may. Back in the days when I was working in advertising, I was working in radio advertising, and one of my clients, this is back in Columbia, Missouri.
Were you selling advertising?
I was just the creative, yeah. Okay. I was on air at a radio station and writing and producing ads for all four of the stations that the company owned locally. And one of the clients was this sort of bar and grill that most of their food went, you know, straight from Sam's Club into the deep fryer right into the college students. You know, it was that just chain of possession there. But they gave me free rein. They just thought I was a creative genius and knew that, you know, I did have some limits of taste, only, you know, because I didn't want to get stuck with an FCC fine. But one of the owners of the station, great guy, Dave Bauer, who literally sounds like this. And Dave was one of those guys, he liked to get active in what the employees were doing. And this was back when the radio station, the group of stations had like six computers that we all shared, aside from the ones that were used for traffic and in the studios and everything. So I was sitting at one of the cubicles with a computer working on some scripts, and he comes by. He's like, "Hey, what are you working on there, Dave?" And I said, "You know, I'm glad you stopped by. Got a question for you. When someone sets themselves on fire, do you think it sounds more like, or is it a whoosh? Is it?" He's what are you working on? Oh, it's a commercial for Johnny's Beanery. Well, you just keep doing that. And nice. And the commercial made it to air.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they loved it. It was all about the hazards of tailgating.
Oh,
and
nice.
Why you
okay.
should you know, start getting your food and drink on before the game at Johnny's Beanery rather than in the parking lot of the stadium.
I thought maybe it had something to do with flatulence.
No. Although you do bring up just something that's been on my mind all day. I don't know if you heard about this gas explosion in Mexico this morning, and I was. I didn't post any myself, but yeah. I was very disappointed not to see any jokes about refried beans
exactly.
and a gas explosion. Yeah. You know, it's just like
gas explosion in Mexico. They call that they call that Thursday morning.
Just like I guess a point of pride that none of my friends who are comedians
that is a little disappointing.
Route. But it was kind of like, come on,
it's,
guys,
it's just
right there.
Laying there.
It is like the
thickly.
Deflated balls jokes,
yes.
like. Like that was like endless, right? Everybody with the deflated balls.
Has society become so politically correct that we can't make jokes about Mexican food and gas anymore?
Yes.
Wow.
We've really lost our way.
We have.
Yeah. Man, that's bad.
But anyway,
I think we've probably beat this to death. But I do feel
like,
that
like an NFL player's ball.
Yeah, I mean,
it was just asking to be
said.
That was
perfect. But the Super Bowl really exemplifies the worst of America in violence and sexism and conspicuous consumption.
Exactly, it is like the apex of consumer culture.
They're the most sexist commercials.
Yeah.
You know, we'll see some women in bikinis probably. We'll see idiot males drinking beer. And then we have Katy Perry at the halftime.
Yeah.
Just like
be a football game and commercials too.
And that's,
yeah.
and that's just in your living room.
That's,
yeah. That's,
sounds like a hell of a Super Bowl party.
Yeah,
I'm there.
Katie usually swings by, but who cares? Right, you're right. I think,
and then to top it all off, the NFL is a nonprofit, and they don't pay taxes,
which is fucking crazy.
Is that like even Tom Coburn from Oklahoma has like he's introduced legislation? I think so, the pro sports something or other, but to get because all of the leagues kind of follow suit. And they're actually a nonprofit organization, and they don't pay taxes. And many of all the teams pay taxes on their revenue and
things like that.
But they all funnel money into the NFL.
Yeah, it's
and that's got like a tax shelter. And Roger Goodell made like $44 million last year. And if you rank him amongst the top 20 corporations, corporations. Sure.
Yeah.
He's in the top 20 as far as compensation, and I just think it's wrong for somebody like Roger Goodell at the NFL, that's a nonprofit, to not have to pay taxes, and then all these corporations that pay for they have to pay for lobbies, they have to work hard to not pay taxes. All of these other
they don't even have to work hard. I apologize for coughing.
Yeah, they don't.
But
exactly.
Yeah,
they don't have a nonprofit status,
right?
And they don't pay taxes, and then
right,
but, it is horse shit.
So you're saying we should offshore the NFL?
Yeah, we should
just to justify their
exactly.
tax-free status.
Yeah, what are they?
They're already playing at least a couple exhibition games a year in England.
Right.
Yeah, I think they did. I know they've been playing one, but maybe they're going to play two next year, maybe.
Now, stupid question. This is changing gears. Another sport. Bucks, the Bucks in Milwaukee Bucks. Milwaukee. What are they?
Man,
what
sport? You just took a left turn.
Yeah, I sure did. I sure did. But that
would be basketball.
Basketball. Yeah, sons of bitches.
It's a ball.
Anyway.
What about the Bucks?
I'm sorry. I just want to say this. In the whole Ponzi scheme thing where the only people who are actually paying are people who pay for tickets and the average American, in Wisconsin where they cut the education by $300 million, they also...
Well, they haven't yet.
Okay, it's happening.
That's the governor is proposing that.
Yeah. Well, the other thing they're proposing is 200 some million to be spent on a new stadium for the Bucks, which they claim will be paid by the taxes paid by the basketball players. But you do the math, you go like, well, obviously they don't make that much money. They're not they're not going to make up a $200 million difference unless you're paying them $2 billion.
Well, it's over time, though. Cumulative.
It is. But even then, it doesn't work out. The numbers just don't work out.
Eventually, 100 years from now.
Right, 100 years from now. And that's this whole thing with, like, in St. Louis, the Rams, the reason the Rams will move or be able to move is because they had an initial agreement when they moved to St. Louis that the St. Louis had to have a stadium that's in, like, the top third in quality of all stadiums. So they built them a new stadium, but now it's been 20 years almost. So they're like, well, you know, you don't have enough of these private, which is the other thing, is so much of it is about the money they make is from the private boxes, which of course does not serve the needs of the community.
I don't know. It keeps those rich motherfuckers off the streets at least for, you know, 3 hours a week.
True. It does cut down executive rape, which I think is probably something we've been ignoring.
Yeah,
there was just some, well, I don't even know.
Our forests are safe, if only for one day a week.
Yeah. There was an incident, and I, you know, reading on the, I don't know. There was an incident at a hockey game. Now, this was not a major, it wasn't NHL, but anyway, some Native American students who had earned the right to go to this hockey game were there, and then they were tormented, and beer was poured on them. And where did it come from in the stadium? The box seats. So... I say, again, I welcome the meteor that's going to destroy, or asteroid, I don't care, I'm not picky.
Comet, celestial
comet.
Body.
Yeah, well, it could be a comet.
It could happen sooner than that, just vote Republican, everybody.
Certainly, that's one way to speed it up.
You want to speed up the demise.
Is to have a whole party built on denial.
If I can segue out of that, one of the funniest
things... Let me derail
the
show after you're done. Go ahead.
Well, one of the funniest things I heard this week was Mitt Romney talking about income inequality.
That's a good one. That is hilarious.
And was he probably saying increased under Obama or something?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Mitt could fix that.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
I mean, this is kind of like how I feel about the Super Bowl. Is if Mitt Romney and Dick Cheney were fighting, I mean, who would you root for?
America.
You want them both to die, don't you?
Yeah, because America would win.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. I don't know. It would disappoint me if one of them survived.
Yeah.
They are there to make George Bush look, that guy's all right. Well, he got manipulated by those.
Well, here's some promising news, and maybe this will make you happy. You probably heard this this last week, that the Koch brothers had a little get-together, had a little barbecue with all their pawns, and they have committed to spending $900 million in the upcoming election. And it's just, to me, it's such a wonderful story because really, I mean, we look back, it's like our founding fathers, like all their dreams are coming true. Like everything that they laid out for our democracy being for sale, it's happening. And it's happening in our lifetime.
Absolutely.
It's so exciting.
I sort of, this is one of those thoughts I like to have shortly before going to bed, helps me sleep at night, is that this is part of a Republican plan to introduce a new source of alternative energy that they'll actually power the turbines by siphoning energy off of the founding fathers spinning in their graves.
Like a Rube Goldberg thing.
You know, it could be.
I like that. Yeah, that could be. That they're solving problems we just aren't aware of.
Now, there's so much anti-Muslim sentiment in the United States.
I should have pronounced it turbines.
Well, no, that could be what's hurting the wind industry. I don't want to invest.